Alright guys, we're back for more Cena Nuts 2. I did change one thing here, which is that stun baton instead of this thing. That seemed really damn weak. Worthless, actually. Maybe it's not worthless, but it seemed really weak. Yeah, we have shit ton of wounded. And still 6 days out. I find it a bit odd that we didn't have a medical center when we built the base, but okay. Maybe it's a new thing. Oh, the Mars combat thing is done. Let's build 2 sentry guns for the base. Let's continue. Hangar, living quarters, generator. Okay, that's great. Yes, living capacity has gone up. Our power capacity too. So we're gonna build a laboratory here. And yeah, as you can notice, you get bonuses, I think, if you build next to each other. Same thing. Weird. I'm not sure how it works. I guess it just flies out, or maybe they lifts out or something. I'm not 100% here. Yeah, you are not building anything. Let's see, how does this thing work now? Armory? My Mars robots? So I can have 8. Oh, it only takes one. Oh, I guess 2 kind of weapons. Let's see here. What's this now? That's a cannon vehicle. The cannon is a vehicle weapon that fires powerful, high-caliber projectiles capable of inflicting heavy damage on single targets. This was the rockets. Powerful explosives that with large blast radius that are very effective at destroying terrain, removing armor. Steel plating. I'm not sure. Oh, it increased armor. Lowers the time units. Let's keep it as it is for now. Yeah. And I talked about that rebreather. It seems that they have removed the rebreather. I think it was an icon up here for. You clicked here and you got a rebreather, but that's gone now. We got a little Mars thing here. We're gonna try out this first. Then this one maybe. What's this? The rangefinder. Increase accuracy, okay. But we want the extra gun. And it's cool. This is cool. Now we wait for more missions here. Something to do. Okay, we probably want to do another aircraft, right? Interceptor. Oh man, okay. Really low on low on founds there. Extraterrestrial craft pose a set of challenges for which humanity is poorly prepared, Commander. Aircraft and weapons that are highly effective against human targets frequently prove utterly useless when employed against UFOs. The main problem is simple. Alien crafts are extremely difficult to track, as modern instruments cannot get a solid fix on the UFO. Locking a missile becomes impossible. This renders any kind of guided munitions useless and leaves autocannons the only effective weapons against alien vessels. Oh, so we didn't have any missiles. Alright. Alright, that explains my disaster of aerial combat. Yeah. This creates a new paradigm for aerial warfare that is highly reminiscent of dogfights from the Second World War. Engagements take place over short distances with positioning of aircraft to maximize the firepower and avoid enemy attacks, being crucial to success. I expect this situation to endure even as our weapon improve. Having spent considerable time integrating the guidance system on our missiles with the interference radars on our interceptors, even I have been unable to create a viable targeting solution that operates much beyond a kilometer. Nonetheless, I suspect my work will still prove useful. Lighter missiles can be mounted in racks of four and utilize a high explosive warhead designated to shred the target with shrapnel. They deliver substantial damage quickly, reducing the amount of time our aircraft needs to spend exposed to enemy fire. Torpedoes are larger missiles designed for use against armored UFOs. They are mounted in racks of two and have a powerful shaped charged warhead designed to penetrate and shatter armor. A more complex guidance system grants them a longer range, useful given it is wise to break enemy armor before engaging with lighter weapons. Both types of launchers are now available for construction. Oh, I have to build them. I see. 6 days to interrogate this one. I think that is probably something the scientists want to do. We can hire you more, but we need more room. But we can get recruit some soldiers. Is it TU? Yeah, Christoph looks great there. Accuracy, strength, everything is very low strength. Calix Angelis looks great. TU looks pretty good. Todd Nelson. Chinese guy. Yeah, let's get those guys for now. Recruit them. 40,000. We're down to 8,000. Damn, that's low. Oh yeah, the medical center is down. So the heal rate should have gone up now, right? 40%. The survival chance. Healing rate should have gone up, so we should be getting men back quicker now. 2 days. Yeah, it's looking better. Alright, new guys coming. Polar cleaner abduction site. Interrupts, let's say that word instead. Interrupt the ongoing operations of these cleaner forces may represent our best opportunity to gather intelligence on their mysterious organization. Persistent. Victory effects. 250,000. 10 minus global. Damn. Okay. Let's launch the combat team here. So we are missing a couple of guys here. We got a grenadier, but we don't have a heavy. See one of the new guys, maybe? Someone with good strength. 61 strength. Todd Nelson. We will change you to a heavy. And if you can, I would want you to have this too. Yes, you can. Let's go with protection. Welcome aboard. We're missing a shield, but I think we're gonna wait with the shield guy. Let's see if Casper Kopnik. Jennifer Scott. Zhang Dalin. Let's get this guy. Welcome aboard, sir. See if we can. Some of these dudes can carry some extra stuff. You can't carry anything. Okay, you carry one of these. You can, but you shouldn't go into close quarters anyway. You can carry. You got some room too. Okay, that's great. Let's launch this. See what they're doing in the Arctic here. Sons of bitches. Commence tactical battle. It's one of those things. Rescue 5 civilians from abduction tubes before the timer runs out. Yeah. Let's see. A cleaner combat team appears to be attempting to abduct the staff of a remote Arctic research facility. We'll have a short period of time before the abduction devices teleport away with civilians inside. Yeah. This reminds me so much of weird stuff like from XCOM 2. Right, first XCOM. To rescue that person. I mean, I understand they're doing more objectives, but I don't know. It's weird to me. Wow, that's a good shot, Isabella. I see one down there. Our sniper go for that one. See another one there. It's the small, the mini tank. Can I hide behind it? Does that give me? I guess it works. Oh, there's another one there. Okay, I don't want to spread out too much now. Oh shit, there's a guy right next to me. Oh. Yeah, the rookie got almost pulverized there. Switch your handgun. Shoot him. Right in the heart. Good job. Okay, but I want you to go here, actually. Okay, let's see what will happen here. They use conventional weapons, like we do. Oh no! And he runs out. Takes a shot. Oh, there's one more. Jesus. Oof. Okay. Blow him up. Oh, that was loud. Look at the destruction. That was very loud. Maybe we can capture one of these guys alive. Oh, you're not next to him? Capture him, if you can. Great. Clean the soldier has fallen unconscious. Run home! You need medicals. You need to help these guys over here. Well, I thought we would run through it, but I guess not. Three out of five. And Yeah, we see one up there and one down there. Let's see if we can get this one. Go there instead. We have 5 turns remaining, so you can go up on the roof. I gotta say, some stuff just feels a lot smoother in this game compared to Xenonauts 1. Like some movements and stuff. Oh no! Oh god. Oh shit. Reaction fire. It's kind of weird that they move then fire. So I think if you think you're safe, you're not. Okay, somehow he missed me somehow. Take your pistol. He got executed. No, I wanna use this thing here. Holy shit. Yeah, that was a big freaking explosion. For some reason it's mega loud. Wow. I gotta love how it explodes though. It's awesome. 80. Nice shot. Yeah, still, even if it's handy, I think this should be more of a penalty to switch around weapons like this. There's another one out there. And I tried, you can't actually have two main weapons in... it seems that the secondary slot is only for light stuff, like sticks and pistols. Alright, let's see what happens. Oh, there's another one. Oh, they shot the civilian next to me. Okay, he still counted as a rescue, I guess. What did I get there? Nice shooting. It's Isabella Bertolini again. Let's see. Target is done. I reached my target. You jump down here? Yes, that is pretty sweet. Stuff like that. Oh god. Okay, I see him there. Let's try the rifle. Wow. Okay. Man. That is an awesome thing. Okay. Let me see another guy. Oh, this accidentally hit him. Let's go back inside. Oh, it took reaction after I got inside. No. Oh no, he shot the civilian. I reacted a bit too quick there. You guys sit here and wait, okay? You'll probably come down. Yeah, there is. Open fire! Open. Try to get him. Oh, just blasted that thing. Okay. Not very high chance here, but you hit him. Suppressed him. Almost. Can we blow him up? Reloading weapons. Alright, thank you. Damn, that's not good. We can throw an A though. He exploded. I do wish they had the ragdolls effect. I love to see guys fly around. Nothing here. I find it funny that half the civilians we have saved has perished. One shot by friendly. Oh, and you moved you. Alright. Let's move then. So you can save this guy here. 7 out of 5. Let's go. I like how dramatic it looks though, the corpses and stuff. Inventory? Oh, look at this. Alien heavy mag rifle. I said earlier that they were using conventional weapons, they are not. Using alien weapons. Yeah, everyone jumps through the windows there. It's another one up there if you can't grab it. Yeah, overall, I mean, there is some stuff I would complain about, but overall, just playing, you know, like this, it feels good. Just wish they hadn't simplified or removed some things. And I wish they put some things under an option, like the health thing and the green outline thing. Oh, mission complete. Okay, I guess it ended with... suddenly... is the timer went down? Mission complete. We got it. So, Sergeant something? What's this? Soldiers will be granted the Crux Solaris if they eliminate 4. Or more hostile units in a single tactical mission. Plus 1 to every attribute. Man, that used to be 5. Golden Star for eliminating a total of 5 hostile units in the career. Okay. So you got 2 damn medals here. Mars. We got 9 cleaner corpses and 1 capture cleaner operative. And Xiang Talin got wounded for 18 days. Lots of ranks and stuff here. I guess we have to check on the list. We got the kills. back to base. Alright, let's see here. Autopsy cleaner. No unique abilities. Look at that guy. Looks human. But buff, I guess. Some kind of tank or some kind of thing. Metal stuff in his brain. Maybe he can't breathe oxygen. The cleaners have played our organization for a long time, Commander. Your efforts on the battlefield have been commendable. The process of unmasking our enemies can now begin, both literally and figuratively. Removal of the customary gas mask and hazmat suit worn by cleaner operatives reveals nothing particularly unusual about them. Though highly effective against environmental hazards, they are of little use against firearms. One presumes their true purpose is simply to conceal the identity of the wearer. Alright. The disrobed bodies are outwardly indistinguishable from normal humans. Both male and female operatives are present, ranging from early 20s to mid 40s. Physical appearances vary, but all appear within acceptable parameters for combat operations. Indeed, only a glance inside the mouth reveals the presence of anything beyond the ordinary. The roof of the mouth is heavily scarred in each case, implying significant surgical intervention. The full extent of this is only revealed by bisection of the skull. Numerous implants are embedded within the brain matter, collectively replacing over a third of the tissue with electronics. Though we would need to capture a live specimen to understand the precise nature of these implants, it seems safe to assume that they represent some form of control device. Sadly, surgical removal does not appear feasible. The loss of so much brain matter means the implants themselves must be compensating for the missing tissue in some manner. Removing them would almost certainly leave the patient in a vegetative state. Cleaner operatives are thus doomed to serve the alien masters for the remainder of their existence, leaving us with no choice but to eliminate them. Thankfully, this should not be unduly difficult. There is no evidence to suggest their implants enhance combat performance, nor that their weaponry is superior to our own. They're not? Okay. We will require more information about the cleaners before disrupting their main operations. Disrupting their operations become a realistic possibility. Inventing text now. However, the importance of such matters relative to our other research priorities is a decision that only you can make. You have to learn to read. We got lots of money. New research projects. Cleaner operations, interrogation a cleaner. Okay. There's more reading coming soon. Hope you enjoy it. What are we doing? Yeah, we're making a plane, right? I just wanna check one thing here. Oh, 3 kills. That chick. Yeah, Bertolini. 7 kills. Impressive. With her, what's that? Just says ballistic rifle, but I guess it's an M4. She has pretty low health. Her accuracy is really high. High reflex and bravery too. Yeah, she is pretty damn good. She's a great rifleman, and she can probably carry something extra now. For destruction, or should we get a Granada. I like the Mars thing. Man, that was really good. You can carry more stuff too. Maybe you want the Granada too. Like that. I like the grenades in this. It feels much better to throw. Yeah, overall it looks great here. They got pretty good equipment. We down one man. One man got wounded. Chinese fella. Zhang Talin. 18 days. Damn, he got really screwed up. Okay. Let's continue. Panic has been reduced all over the world. That's great. No! Place only image. Research art will follow in the future update. No! Interrogation Python. That's a shame, Vida. You're not going to know what they're up to. Anything. That sucks. That's why you should wait for the full game. Oh, and we can see it's building there. I assume I need another hangar. Gonna build it down here. I wish the base had a totally different design. Makes me feel all autistic. Damn. Need to get a cleaner. Clean operations. 50% cleaner HQ location progress. Alright. We are curious about everything here. There's so much stuff going on, but we are very curious about alien magnetic weapons. Study of various recovered alien firearms that all appear to function based upon a common set of electromagnetic principles. Let's say we got really curious about this since we saw that the cleaners also use these kind of weapons. We want to know why they're not using ballistics. Why they prefer weird weapons like that. Was it something else I was doing? 1 hour. I was thinking about something, but now I forgot it. Damn it. Okay, let's continue. It's done. We got a new plane. Oh yeah, we got these things. $100,000 DM. Oh, I can only build one. It's done. Oh, take it easy. Now let's see how this works here. You have no weapons. No armor. Damn, I have to... Okay, let's give you autocannons. We need to make armor for you. And okay, and this is more interesting now. So Angel One got a missile now, and we need to make armor for you. But we can't because it's very, very expensive. See, can we sell something? What's it worth? 5,000? Yeah, we're probably not gonna sell anything. Just we can sell the capture cleaner, capture slam. Let's see who you're gonna try it. The corpses? Yes. So we sold one captured alien to a government. I guess we sold it maybe to the American government. Maybe they put some pressure on us. Ongoing cleaner activity has increased panic in all JSK regions by 10. We need to eliminate the cleaner organization to prevent this. Alright. So... everyone is on plus. We got 1.3 million. That is sweet. No, I don't know if we should build another base already. need one of these. One of these. So that's already 200. How much does it cost? Construct a new base. 750. Okay. I think we will wait a little with that. I mean, we can't do it, but we can't do anything else. Complete alien hyperdrive research project. Damn. Okay. For some reason, that feels pretty far away. How is this thing coming on? 9 days? Do we need another barrack? I think we do. Hell yeah, look at the money just... Oh shit! The money just... keeps going away. Not even sure we can do anything. No, we can't reach. That's why we need another base there. Damn it. Okay, that thing is done too. I don't think you guys have to make anything right now. We can make one more of these. And you need the armor. I got 5 armor. And you got a sign winder. So we got the alien magnetic weapons here. 110 damage plus 5 armor penetration. Armor destruction, unlimited quantity. There are a variety of different magnetic weapons employed on the battlefield by the extraterrestrials and their cleaner allies, each with their own unique strengths and weaknesses, but all appear to utilize the same coil gun technology to accelerate their projectiles. The design is relatively straightforward. The barrel contains a linear arrangement of powerful electromagnetic rings, which flips polarity as the bullets move through them. The projectile is first pulled towards the ring, then pushed away once it has passed. As the electronics in the gun are capable of timing this process to a microsecond, the weapon is still capable of high rates of fire. Magnetic weapons thus act much like conventional firearms, yet possesses significantly higher muscle velocities. It is notable that the shape and ballistic properties of the ammunition bear a striking resemblance to the 5.56 mm and 7.62 mm rounds, and the wounds they inflict are almost indistinguishably from human equivalent. Although they are still superior to human weapons, I suspect the extraterrestrials have access to rather more deadly weapons than these alien magnetic weapons. They are relatively low-tech design or a species capable of interstellar travel, and the close resemblance to our own weapons is likely no accident. I believe they are primarily intended to help mask the presence of extraterrestrial forces on our planet. Well, it does look a bit alien or high-tech. Unfortunately, the extraterrestrials have taken precautions to ensure their own weapons cannot be easily turned against them. The firing mechanism contained a DNA lock that prevented the weapon being fired by anyone except the intended owner. Easy to defeat in a laboratory setting, but virtually impossible to circumvent on a battlefield. Nonetheless, we have gained much from our study of these weapons. The electromagnets within the weapon are vastly more powerful than anything humanity can manufacture, and can easily be extracted and integrated into human technology. Much can be improved using such ultramagnets, not least our own ballistic weapons. It should be relatively straightforward, even by the low standards of our engineering department, okay, to construct barrel-mounted acceleration devices that can be fitted to our weapons to improve their damage. Okay, new engineering projects. Accelerated pistol... Okay, we just unlocked a shit ton of stuff. Oh, we can already make them? Alright. Well, let's go with the cleaner operation. Analysis of the recovered cleaner equipment may allow us to trace their operations, revealing vulnerabilities our organization can exploit. Let's do that. 12 days. So that, oh, we can already make them. It takes alien alloys, though. Let's ditch that thing for now. We can make... Should I make two pistols? And then we go from there. So that was pretty quick to get new weapons, I think. Sidewinder, yeah, they're working on pistol now. Great. Western Town, bad news, Commander. The aliens attacking a major population center. Our founding nation expect us to protect them against this sort of attack. So it won't look good if we don't respond. Panic level 50, damn. Yeah, we need to respond. Terracite. Shit, already. We got a heavy grenadier. What are we missing? I guess, Rifleman? Norbert Joska? Get another grenade, sir. And join the squad. Let's go for mission. Oh, it's night. Wait. He said one day. So can we wait until daylight? It's daylight now, right? Yeah. You don't want to make it too dangerous. This is our first Terra mission. I have no idea what's gonna be. I'm hoping we get local military forces. Since it is the United States, should be something, right? The aliens have placed a number of powerful explosive devices in the local area. If not defused, we believe the resulting explosion will kill tens of thousands of civilians. You must clear the area of extraterrestrial force so the bombs can be neutralized. Each surviving alien bomb will grant 5 alienium. Surviving bomb? Not sure. Oh, it's a lizard! I'm not sure what that means, really. Each surviving bomb? Fire! He has armor, 1. I don't think he liked that very much. Yeah, this guy... this guy can take some more punishment. You... there's 0% chance of reaching that. Okay. Well, I would like to kill him, save this military guy there. Sniper can take him out. Oh, you shot the robot! Why did you shoot a robot? Yeah, the range is feels a little bit weaker than in the OG game. Okay, we'll hope he survives. Maybe I can throw him some smoke. Oops! I hurt him. Okay, let's see how it goes. That was a bit funny. Someone, no, here he comes. Oh, he ran into the fire. He looks armored already. Shit, they're all over the place. Nice reaction. Run away! These guys feels a bit tougher. I need you to fight with us. Enemy Overwatch. Scott Thomas. Can you blow up his cover? Maybe him too. He's gone. Alright, we see this fella here. That's some excellent shooting. I think we saw some more movement, didn't we? I'm not sure, but I don't want to run out too far now. Pretty nice, cozy little place down here. Sit and wait for them if they wanna come and kill us. Let's send out the robots. Yes, just sit tight. Ah, yeah, there's one more there. Shoot him! He's coming straight for us! Jesus! It's a friendly shooting something. Yes, there's combat somewhere. Let's see, nobody. Okay, you have a grenade. Let's see if you can hit him. Huh. Okay, that thing didn't blow up the cover. Took some damage, but yeah, it's much weaker than the. Nice shooting. Than the high explosive thing. So that's pretty cool. But the game got different kind of stuff like that. Mary Adams. Right, guys, sit tight. We can go out there, secure this area. Move it, man. Let's go. Yeah, something got shot. Oh, is that the bomb? I guess we don't want to destroy that thing, right? Civilian shooting at him. Chris, you're all alone here. Can you slow it down? Yes. Good job. People in the way. God damn it, soldier. probably can't shoot now. No. We can try to get a man on the roof there. See a Shakova. Go up there. Let's go send out the truck. Oh, there's another one of those things. So, if the bombs survive, we get bonuses. I think it was. So, do not blow up the bombs, in other words. Alright, I haven't moved you. You can sit tight. Oh shit, there's another guy. He came up here. Oh shit, how can he miss so close? Well, he did suppress him. Yeah, I really like some stuff here. Like you can turn the camera and stuff. Okay, we wounded him a little. Oh, you're taking a long run. Oh, I thought she would. Yeah. It's probably better if you go up there. Maybe you can fire. Damn it. Chris. Wanna do something crazy? Try to save that civilian inside. Sniper, can you shoot that far? Yes, you can. 59. Hit him, and you see the soldier there. I really doubt he will make it. Large restaurant there. I haven't secured this small convenience store. I guess we'll do that. Isabella. Send one guy with the drone or the tank. Dead civilian there. Oh shit, it's three inside. Yeah, that soldier was, he was doomed. Here comes his friend. What are you gonna do? Okay, I want you to take your heavy gun. And I really don't want you to blow anyone up here that you care for. Enemy spothead. Alright. Shoot him, pin him down if you can. Good work. Too far away. Is it worth to do this risky thing? Wow, okay. Oh, get back. Shit, Chris might be in trouble here. Okay, managed to suppress him. I'm gonna put your hair on standby. Just blast through the doors and everything.
Let's move.
Well, there's nothing there. And the sniper? Oh, the sniper. Yeah, we're gonna have to move you. Alright, let's see what happens. Total miss.
Don't come up here, civilian. Oh, he's coming down.
And he runs away. Man, you're an idiot. Thought you wanted revenge, your dead friend. Yeah, how do you even miss with a shotgun like that? All right, sniper. 100%, damn. Yeah, this guy can take some serious damage. There, he died. I think we got him right in the heart. Scary thing is, though, they still have stuff around. Yeah, I really like the destruction. This destruction feels a lot cleaner, better now it's 3D. Yeah, these guys really need to stick together here, in case they run into something. You guys, move up too. Let's go. You can hide behind the bomb. Oh my god. Okay. No, we already moved you. Shit. Panicked a bit. Okay, now we know. Might need reinforcements. Come down here. Tank. Don't think you can fire, right? Not now, at least. Man. Three of them just hanging around here. Oof. Oh shit, it's coming right up. Oh, you could fire. Yeah. Oh no, it's coming from the roof. Oh god. Oh shit. But these are fucking aggressive, man. Shoot him! Shoot him! Don't run! Alright, you need to blast this guy. Good. It's a shame that it kind of locks up like that. I think it has something to do with the sound, to be honest. But you have no grenades or anything? You can use this and get them both. Blow up their cover. Ugh. Or just eliminate that guy straight up. And you can shoot him. Damn. That's impressive. And there's still more around. Oh man, still more dudes around. That is scary. Because I don't think our luck will hold up much longer. Spears, hellas, come on, man. Everyone, collect themselves. I really hope they change that animation. She just stands there. She looks so weird. I mean, is this a real weapon she's holding? And she is a professional, I hope. Oh, there's the alien. That guy hasn't done much, he's just running around like an idiot. Alright, let's see if we can get this guy. Oh, where did he go? Did he go up on the roof? It's time to blast. Alright, we don't Oh, there he is! Oh god, he went in there. Mary Adams, what are you doing? Can we get out of here? Not really. Oh no. I can put this right next to him? Shit, I was certain she would. Can do the mega risky thing. Took some damage, but we should be able to get him now. Oh yes, I got did some smaller wounds there, some sharpen. Robot survived too. Mission successful. No deaths. Man, a lizard man. They didn't fire anytime against me, but they did scare the shit out of me. So we got 10 civilian corpses. Those had the same name. Four locals survived. Alienum. Magnetic weapons. And we got award for courage. Soldiers will be granted the award for courage on successful completion of our terror mission. Yeah. Norbert Joska got wounded. We are collecting medals. Let's see. Did we reduce? Not worldwide, but reduce it locally, I think. Yeah, big boy here. The reptilian creature known as Sibilian is an imposing physical specimen, measuring roughly 2 meters tall and weighing almost 150 kilograms. It appears to be warm-blooded for a lizard, all right, with sharp claws and savage teeth that imply a carnivorous diet and predator origin. The majority of the body mass can be attributed to the unusually heavy skeleton and thick scaled hide of the creature, with the remainder consisting largely of raw muscle. Unsurprisingly, this hulking physique makes the creature rather difficult to kill in battle. Furthermore, rumors are circulating among your soldiers that civilians possess some form of rapid regenerative ability. A plausible claim, giving almost 10% of their blood consists of coagulants and unspecialized stem cells. Capturing a live specimen should allow us to verify the facts of the matter. Yeah, might be not be so easy. Despite its fearsome appearance, the subject possesses a well-developed brain that implies only slightly less intelligence than an average human. Compared with one of our engineers. Again, jab at engineers. However, these creatures are notable, ponderous by nature, and reportedly react slowly to unexpected situational changes. Thankfully, the remarkable physical attributes of a civilian are somewhat offset by their vision, which is superb at short distances but rapidly becomes indistinct as range increases. Perhaps implying the natural habitat of these creatures is thick vegetation. Civilians are thus best engaged at distance, beyond the reach of their deadly claws, and where the marksmanship is compromised by the poor. I said, yeah. So they have civilians are capable of attacking nearby units with the powerful claws. This attack has poor armor penetration, but can cause heavy damage to unarmored units. It also has a very high chance of causing bleeding damage. Damn, that's cool. They can slash now. Oh boy. Looks badass. And it comes armored now, as a standard it seems. Scaled skin. This unit is a thick scaled skin that provides a measure of protection against damage. The unit gains the stated amount of extra armor in addition to any provided by the actual armor. Okay, he is regenerating. This unit has the ability to regenerate damage sustained in combat. At the start of each turn, it will gain the stated number of hit points. This also heals any bleeding wounds. Damn. Poor eyesight, it's not yet implanted. Shame. Wonder what. Yeah, because they kind of seem like they had poor eyesight. So what are we doing? We're doing the pistols. What are we researching? Cleaner operations. Another hangar. That's great. And this one is done soon. I'm thinking, should we make another aircraft already? We're just gonna wait a little. Make some weapons first. Laboratory is done. Now we can get some more. We can hire some more. 16. Okay, so we got one bonus. Wow. 300,000. That was expensive. So they are in transit now. Just keep going. Staff is here. Do I have to put them? Are they doing? Are they already here? The ceaseless interruptions hardly enhance my productivity. You say it, we build it. Yeah, like yeah, weapons take a long time to make. Is there I haven't noticed that yet, but the soldiers? There is a casualty list. But yeah. We haven't training. Training capsule shows how many training slots are available at this base versus the number of soldiers stationed at the base. For more information on how the training system works, see the training rate tooltip below. Can I? How do I? Is there a building? I don't want to know what exactly it does. Training rate is the amount of progress each soldier stationed at the base will gain in each of the attributes every hour they're stationed at this base, provided you have sufficient training capacity. Hmm. 0%. I have a training thing. I don't have any. Oops. I really don't have a training base. Did I forget to build that thing? I did. Holy shit. Let's build it next to the medical. That's not good. I thought I had one. Damn. 20 days. Okay, so we have men can't train at all at the base. That's a miss. I mean, yeah, one pistol is done. So, who should get the pistol? It would be cool to get the Grenadier, maybe. Because she is using it a lot. I'm kind of thinking, should I use the shield unit? I'm not sure. We're missing a rifleman, I think. Who wanna go on a mission? You've been on one mission. Let's take a total newbie. Christoph. You will join. Yes, GM. What is that? Sergeant something? Let's see it somewhere. What it is? I can't rename soldiers now? Yeah, I can. Can I rename Chris? I can. I thought you couldn't name special rename special soldiers. I guess you can. So damn it, 30 to 28. Destruction 2, minus 2 armor. Penetration, it has penetration. Armor. Alright. Well, we want a shotgun. Only 25,000. Pistol is more expensive than the shotgun. Alright, let's continue. Until something happens here. Medium. Well, that's different. Oh no. I want all three to go and get it. Living quarters. Oh, we built one more of those. So it's a main craft, a medium one. It's saved. So let's try it. Just try it. Wow, what's that? Who got missiles? So I probably I can place them? Okay. I didn't know that. So I want you to. Oh, it's turning. Wow, they can shoot from the back and everything. Yeah, I really suck at this. What can you fire? sure why you're not shooting your missiles. We shut it down. I will never do that again. I have no fucking idea what's going on. yep, we're going. Launch aircrafts. We are basically ready, right? Yeah. Alright, let's do this. And we are gonna pause. Overhauling aircraft, 13 days. You can rush it for 250,000. Holy shit, yeah, that thing took some serious damage. I have no idea what I'm doing. Why it didn't send any of the missiles? I have no clue. But yeah, we're gonna stop here. Oh no, it's night. Okay, we're gonna have to wait until it's daylight, I think. Yeah, we're gonna stop here, and well, thanks for watching, and I'll see you all next time. Goodbye.